The content in this podcast is for informational purposes only and is not intended to diagnose any medical condition, replace the advice of a healthcare professional, or provide any medical advice, diagnosis, or treatment. Copyright 2020 Fireteam Whiskey, LLC, all rights reserved. Welcome to the Warrior Wellness Podcast, a podcast for military members, veterans, and first responders focusing on fitness, health, nutrition, and biohacking. Our mission with this podcast is to introduce America's heroes to lifestyle habits and hacks that will help them live healthier, happier lives, and in turn, be fit enough to continue their support of their communities and country.
Welcome to another episode of the Warrior Wellness Podcast. I'm your host, former Army Captain Stephanie Lincoln, and today our guest is Dr. Christy Harvell, and she is the founder and owner of Health by Design Florida. She is a chiropractor, a clinical nutritionist, a kinesiologist, and a NRT therapeutic provider. So that's nutritional response therapy provider. And she'll tell you all about that in the interview. And today's topic is discussing with her, who's an expert on supplements, and that's what she does in her clinical nutrition and NRT practice, is helping her patients find the appropriate supplements for their own biological needs. So we're going to talk about why would we supplement and what specific supplements maybe we should consider in our biohacking and health journey. Well, thank you so much, Dr. Christy, for being on the Warrior Wellness Show. And this is a really awesome topic because I get questions all the time from our Fireteam Whiskey participants about supplementing. What supplements should I be taking? You know, what kind of dosage? Is a multivitamin enough? So we're going to kind of pare down and get into the kind of the bullet points of supplementation, because we certainly could talk about this probably for the rest of the day.
Right.
We're going to keep it short. So we'll give you what you need to make good decisions on the supplement side of things. And we had to turn to the expert, Dr. Christy Harvell. So right out the gate, first question, why supplement? And why can't we get everything we need from food?
Right. I get that question all the time too. And I always say, like, I'll go to bat 24/7 with anybody who disagrees with me. Like, supplementation is an absolute necessity. And the real easy answer is, like, it's impossible in the world that we live in today with how much stress we're under, you know, especially if we want to be high performers with athletics or our careers or whatnot. Like, our bodies are just under too much stress where it's impossible to get the nutrients we need from the food. So that's the first part of the answer, is we just, the nutrition isn't enough. And the second part is because the food today doesn't have the nutritional density that the same food even like in the 1920s and 30s had. And that's probably a whole nother podcast and conversation about soil quality and, you know, nutrient availability in the foods, even when we are making the proper food choices.
Yeah, no, that's a good point. Yeah, and if you, I've definitely heard some podcasts on this, and if you Google soil depletion, you just get ready to get really depressed, because it is dire. It's a really horrible issue that really nobody's talking about, except for on the biohacking world and the health industry world, or holistic health anyway. So yeah, that's a really good point. So, you know, no matter how good your nutrition is, you know, because that's the other kind of side of the coin here, is I do have people, and I'm sure you get this all the time, Dr. Christy. Well, I eat healthy. You know, I eat my vegetables. I eat lots of it. You know, I have salad every day. La, 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 la. I don't eat, you know. So the point is, it doesn't matter how healthy or unhealthy your diet every day is, you're still probably not getting what your body needs.
That's true. And then if you think on top of that, like the amount of stress our bodies are under, you know, the world is not the same world it used to be. So our bodies are constantly under attack from different chemical pollutants and heavy metal toxins. You know, EMF, here's another whole topic for 5G, you know, the EMF pollution in the world. And then on top of that, we don't really rest, right? We can take work home with us. Like right now, this whole pandemic, like people, like within 24 hours, we're able to completely figure out how to work from home, but there's no pause, you know? So that's what I'm saying. In addition to like how toxic the world is and all the stressors our bodies are under, we just can't recover from that without supplementation. And the food is not enough to keep up with us.
Yeah. And I dare any of you listening to this right now, raise your hand if you are never stressed.
You know, no hands up.
No hands up. We can't see you right now, but we know that there's no hands up. So we could do a whole different podcast. We might have to have you back, Dr. Christie, just talking about all the biological mechanisms that break down when you're under so much stress, which is such an amazingly important topic for our firefighter and first responder and police and EMT and hotshots and military, you know, just listening to this podcast, all of that entire group definitely should be aware of those kind of mechanisms that break down when you're under constant stress. So we'll have to do another podcast on that.
We have a whole fight or flight conversation.
Yes, yes. All right, so now that we know we cannot, it's physically impossible to get everything we need from our food, and that's why we need to supplement. Everybody needs to supplement, but how can you tell what your body needs of more of certain things or others, and why you need to add a supplement, or what specific supplement do you need?
Right, so that's kind of, for me, a difficult question to answer because I'm a kinesiologist, so I kind of feel bad for people who don't have kinesiology either as their profession or as, you know, have a practitioner that they use, because it really eliminates all that guesswork as far as what exactly your body does need. But without kinesiology, there's still some ways to kind of tell what's going on. A lot of it's by, you know, if you're craving certain foods, you might not know exactly what nutrient you're deficient in, but people don't really know, like sweet cravings, the body is looking for some kind of nourishment. Salt cravings, it's probably a mineral deficiency. Even like chocolate cravings, like a lot of women, you know, crave chocolate at a certain time of the month, and it's probably a magnesium deficiency. So there's just, you know, there's different things. And if you think about doctors yesteryear, before we had all this technology, what did they do? Well, they looked at you. You know, and so what I encourage people to do is look in the mirror regularly, you know, kind of see if you're seeing subtle signs of, you know, your hair doesn't look the same way, or it's falling out, or it's dry or brittle. Same thing with the skin, you know, fine lines or redness or marks, ear nails, ridges, you know, all sorts of different things. Acupuncturists look at your tongue analysis. So there's some things that you can do and just look online to see what is this a sign of deficiency of. It's kind of fun. And also be cautious, because when you start looking up medical things and do a Google image search, you're going to see some stuff.
Yeah. Yes, exactly. You might get way more information than you really need, right? Yeah,
totally. Totally.
Yeah. And probably half of it's not right.
So yeah, and there you have to look at your sources too. That's true. You do need to be able to look at your sources and know that it's not just somebody trying to sell you something.
Exactly.
It's not funded by a pharmaceutical company or, you know, something weird like that.
Mm-hmm. So, you know, what you're saying is there are some kind of telltale signs, cravings, things maybe that are happening with your skin and your hair and your nails. Mm-hmm. You know, levels of energy, you know, cycles throughout the day. So, you know, the best case scenario would be to talk to a kinesiologist or a nutritional response tester, in person. That would be the best, right? But,
push on your arm and muscle test you. So it's
right.
This technology is something that they would actually address your body specific needs. So you would come out with a customized nutrition program.
Right, because your body is giving signals, and people like you are trained to see those signals and feel those signals and pick up on those to customize a supplement plan. So I, you know, a shameless plug here, I have been seeing Dr. Christie for probably over 2 years now, and I get a customized supplement plan from her because she has the skills to be able to tell what my body needs. But you know, if you cannot, if you don't have a kinesiologist or a nutritional response tester in your area to physically see, and now with the whole lockdown thing, you can do virtual appointments with people like Dr. Christie, so they can ask those questions. Yes, it would be better if they could see you in person and get those, you know, feel your body and push on those little pressure points and figure out what's going on. But they can kind of maybe give you a general kind of educated guess, I guess you would say.
Yeah.
On
subjective. Yeah, there's some subjective tools where we can take a health history online or over a phone call or virtual chat and kind of get an idea of what's really going on, because very much we don't like to give a pill for a problem, right? Like anybody can go look up, like there's that book Prescription for Nutritional Healing that anybody can go look up in their local grocery store, health food supplement store, and look up a problem and symptom and get like a 3-page dissertation on like all these different pills and products and supplements and nutrients that you should take. But that's not addressing the body as a whole. That's not trying to get to the root of the problem. So somebody like myself who is trained, we would prefer to see you in person and be able to muscle test you and press on your arm. But even in the absence of an in-person visit, we're going to scrutinize your health and your symptoms a lot differently than somebody else who's still looking at a symptomatic type of an approach.
Right. Because there's some commonalities. I mean, obviously you've been doing this for a very long time. And, you know, you hear the same group of cluster of symptoms, you know, and they all respond really well to a certain class of supplements, you know, so you can make a really good educated guess if you're seeing somebody virtually. So I would definitely encourage you, if you're listening to this right now and you don't have somebody, a kinesiologist or a nutritional response practitioner in your area, you can definitely reach out to Health by Design, and we will put those links to her website on how to contact her and make those appointments in the show notes, of course. So the next question I have for you, Dr. Christie, is why isn't a multivitamin sufficient enough? I mean, isn't that what all we need, you know, the A to Z, you know, and we're good to go?
Yeah, like an all-in-one, right? That's my favorite. Like, that's just such the American way, right? Like, just give it all in one pill. Well, the truth is, if you could get all your vitamins in one product, your pill would probably be the size of this laptop, right? Like you'd have to swallow that. Well, that's one good reason why it can't just be an all-in-one. Like it would be a huge, massive pill. You wouldn't be able to swallow it. But also, like, there's certain cofactors that you need, right? And there's also certain things like you can't take calcium and iron together because they contraindicate each other. They like, literally prevent you from absorbing it. So, like, if you don't know these rules and you just take this pill that's promising to give you all your nutrition for the whole entire day, chances are you're not even going to absorb half of the stuff that's, you know, marketed to you on that label. So that's a big reason.
Yeah. And the other side issue to that is if you have very poor gut health, you're not absorbing hardly anything anyway. So you're just literally just pooping out what you just took.
Yeah, it can be really like frustrating for people because it's a waste of money. And a lot of times by the time people come to me, they have been everywhere else and wasted a lot of time, money, and effort to not get a result. And unfortunately, those people kind of leave with a bad taste in their mouth just about diet and nutrition and about having the ability to heal themselves because it hasn't worked for them otherwise, you know, and that's the hard part. So just kind of have to look at this from a different angle.
Yeah, absolutely. And I was one of those people, and I know your backstory too, and you have to check out Dr. Christie's or the Health by Design's YouTube page for, and she does a lot of talks and she talks about her story and how she ended up doing what she does. But you know, for me, I suffered since the age of 5 from migraines and chronic daily headaches. And not once and over, I mean, how many doctors, how many pills, how many MRIs I had over the years, not once did any of my providers ever even suggest that I take a magnesium supplement. And, you know, and then I started seeing you, and that was one of the things that my body needed right away. And boom, guess what? I hardly ever have a headache. And when I do, it's usually because I'm dehydrated. So, I mean, it's crazy because I know we talk about the importance of supplementation, but if you're listening to this and there's something chronic that you've just been suffering from for just years and years and years, and you've literally tried everything and the kitchen sink, most likely it is some sort of nutritional deficiency long-term that's your body has just needing. And it could really be like that, like take it and boom, like your body just is like, ah, finally I got what I needed. And it just immediate like resolution of your symptoms. So it really can seem like miracle cure for some of these things.
Right. Right. Exactly. Well, the body is always talking to you. Like, I love that you said that, you know, but unfortunately with some of the traditional medicine, it's that we numb it and suppress it. So some of the traditional medications, while, you know, it's posted and published that there's common side effects just from the medication itself, what I talk with people about is like the larger risk of constantly medicating and suppressing the simple symptoms and just stuffing it down and going on with your life is that you lose the inner communication with the body. Like, you literally stop having that inner awareness. The body can't talk to you anymore because you're numbing the very symptoms that are trying to tell you, hey, I don't like this environment. Hey, I don't agree with that food. Hey, there's something poor in the air quality that's, you know, stressing me out. You numb that and you lose the ability to communicate with the body. And now the only way the body can tell you something's wrong is to shout. And at that point, it's not just a mild headache or body aches or some mild digestive discomfort. It might have to be something huge to get your attention, like a heart attack or some kind of like morbidity or chronic diagnosis, that now it's like a lot bigger problem. It might be more than just supplements can handle at that point. You know what I mean?
Yeah. And doctors are, you know, general physicians are in the business of suppressing your symptoms. They're not in the business of getting to the root cause. Kinesiologists are in the business of getting to the root cause. There's a reason why your body is yelling and giving you those symptoms, because there's something going on. So it's not just about making those symptoms go away. Sure, that can be relieving in the short term, but that still means the problem's there. And it's only getting worse and worse, and you're just keeping suppressing the symptoms. So then the result is, like you said, something major happening, some major breakdown. So it's going to take longer to heal that.
Right. And then you have less options. So the chances that something at that point, like diet and nutrition and exercise being the cure for you, you know, you might be looking at something more invasive with higher risk factors like drugs and surgery and procedures at that point. So as a chiropractor, as my background in philosophy, we want to be get in there as soon as possible and be as proactive when we have choices and when we, you know, can listen to those small minor telltale signs that there's some kind of breakdown or deficiency.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Awesome. All right. So my next question is, so, you know, I wanted for you to give us an example of maybe a particular supplement that has a huge effect on how your body works, and just, and something common that a lot of people in general may not be getting enough of from their food.
Yeah. There's so many. I'm going to have like, I love supplements. That's my little dish. Like that's my, I don't know if I can tip it far enough for you to see in there.
that's a lot of supplements.
Yeah, so I love supplements. They keep me going because I just never stop. But if I had to think of something that is super common, it kind of goes back to two of our conversations before about how much stress our body's under and the depletion in the soil. And so it's, the answer is minerals. Mm-hmm. So almost every single process in our body requires minerals. Every single cellular process is like literally has to have minerals in order for your cells to work properly, in order for your nerve impulses to flow, your whole entire electrical system. And when we stress our bodies, whether it's physical or emotional stress, we deplete our minerals really quickly. And when I say minerals, most people immediately think of like, oh, calcium and magnesium, and those are common, but there are smaller trace minerals that are not in our soil anymore. And that's what we were talking about. Even when people are making the proper food choices and buying organic and getting higher quality produce in their body, chances are those trace minerals aren't even in there. So those are things like you know, selenium and copper and zinc and molybdenum and things that you probably haven't even ever heard or know how to spell that used to be in the food, you know, in the quality foods in the 20s and 30s and 40s. And then once they started changing commercial farming practices, that's not even replenished into the soil anymore.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the mass industry of our food and our water as well, because our water is so processed and filtered. You know, they used to just, you know, draw it from the well. Like, it was in contact with all the minerals, and you're getting the wonderful minerals from the earth. And now our water is so overprocessed and bleached and chlorined and filtered and enhanced with fluoride that we're not getting it even from our water.
Right. So now it's so funny, right? Because they sell this alkaline water and everybody's talking about alkalizing your body and getting rid of the acidity. Well, minerals are what naturally alkalizes the water. But yeah, you're right. If it was just from a running well or spring, it would have the minerals naturally occurring as it runs over the rocks, and that's how the minerals content gets in the water. But now they strip it and process it and do all the things, and now then add the minerals back into it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. And then, you know, with the farming practices with mass industry and you know, these massive food farms, you know, they use so many pesticides, and they don't, you know, it used to be in the traditional kind of holistic farming practices that our ancestors used, were, you know, they kept animals on the land that they were going to farm on, and all the, you know, the poop and stuff was in the soil, and that, you know, then they moved the cattle to a different field, and then they grew on that field. So that's with all the wonderful minerals and things that the plants needed to grow and to be nutrient dense. And then they would flip-flop them back and forth. That doesn't happen anymore. We just have these massive, you know, millions of acres of farmland, and they just spray pesticides on it, and they spray, you know, nutrients on it, chemical nutrients, and just keep growing and growing and growing on the same plot of land.
Yeah, it's just about volume.
Yeah. So that's why minerals is such a common issue, and that's why most people need to supplement with minerals. What are some, I mean, other than taking, you know, whole food supplements, like what they could get from you, is there something that maybe we could get from the grocery stores to you know, add to our foods to get a little bit more minerals?
Yeah, I mean, fruits and vegetables are huge, as you know, and then nuts and seeds are also really rich in minerals, and those are high protein, low carb snacks. So I know in the keto world they're somewhat acceptable.
Absolutely, except for our carnivore friends. But another one is the, you know, kind of the war against salt.
Yeah, that's true. So Himalayan sea salt is something that's super easy. And it's also like the dirtier the salt looks, like the more coloration that's in there, the more those trace minerals that I'm talking about would be in it. And like, I'm a salt addict, but I'm not talking about iodized table salt, you know, and that's a good point. Like, it's a myth. People are afraid to salt their food because of high blood pressure, and real Himalayan sea salt does not cause high blood pressure. It's only the iodized table salt, because it's only sodium and chlorine. That's all that sodium chloride is, table salt. It has nothing, no other minerals other than those two things. So
yes, exactly.
It's not balanced.
Right. So Himalayan sea salt, you know, as pure as possible. Even salt from, I like to use Real Salt, the brand Real Salt. It comes from,
that's what I have.
Yep. Yeah. So that comes from like caves in Utah. So it's straight from the earth, you know, so it's very, very pure. And you'll look at it and you'll be like, wow, it looks dirty, right?
Yeah. The dirtier, the better when we're
exactly.
talking about salt.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So this kind of leads into, all right, so we know we need to supplement. We know that we, most people do need to supplement, especially with minerals, but why can't I just go to, you know, a drugstore, Walgreens or GNC, and just, you know, just get a basket, just fill my basket with a bunch of pills and just take them?
It's a good question. And the answer is because, most of the supplements that are in the stores are synthetic, meaning that they're not from a whole food source. So I always like to say, like, every 6 months or so, the traditional news will say, you know, have some kind of story about supplementation and criticize supplements, saying that, you know, there's no need to supplement and supplements are more harmful than they are good for you and you're just wasting your money, kind of a thing. Well, what they're talking about is the synthetic stuff that's very readily available over the counter in the stores. So I'm not in disagreement with part of that statement. The truth of it is that the best way to get your nutrition is from food. Like, you do need to eat a balanced, healthy diet. And so the word supplement means to supplement an already healthy diet and lifestyle. So you still have to have the foundational dietary part in there, but the stuff in the store is not whole food. So the second best you have to eat, number one, is eat your food. Number two is get supplements from a whole food source. So, like, I brought in a bottle of something in here. You know, when you read a whole food vitamin label, you're going to see things like pea vine and carrots and reishi mushrooms. You're going to see things like buckwheat. So it sounds like food, right? It's not all those chemicals. So that's the whole food source of supplements. And the reason is because that's how the body processes nutrition, right? Like, in the divine wisdom of the whole world, food is grown in a way that has all the cofactors and nutrients and minerals and everything you need to digest it, absorb it, and get the most benefit out of it. So when you start taking things over the counter that are just isolates, like just a fraction, one single nutrient extracted from a whole food source, or chemically made to look like the real vitamin complex, it doesn't react in the body the same way. There's no way that the body can recognize that as a food source. So it takes more energy for the body to break it down into something useful, and you probably aren't even going to absorb any of it anyway. And then in some cases, worst case scenario, which is more common than you think, these things are coming from coal tar or from, you know, chalk, or even sometimes like waste material from film developing. They use all the scrap material to make vitamins really cheap. And then it's actually more toxic to your body. It's actually looked at as a foreign substance or a chemical that the body needs to detox. Mm-hmm. So it's just not the same.
Yeah, which stresses your body out more, and then the whole cycle continues, right?
Yeah, there was actually a study about vitamin E causes heart disease. Well, most people take vitamin E for blood quality and for connective tissue and for heart issues, right? But what they're talking about is synthetic vitamin E. And so if you understand biochemistry and you know the different path, like inflammation pathways, whole food vitamin E goes down the anti-inflammatory pathway, whereas synthetic vitamin E goes down the inflammation pathway. So you just have to really understand your biochemistry and how these things are utilized and processed and seen in the body to understand that. And that's the, you know, problem with research is they can twist it any old way they want to. If somebody wants to prove that vitamin E is bad for you, well, poof, they can create a whole research study and they'll have you believe all vitamin E is created equally. That's not true.
Right. Yeah, that's a good point. Yeah, absolutely. So that was awesome information, really, really good informational kind of summary about supplements, why we should supplement, and what kind of supplements to take, and how to find out what supplements you need to take. So definitely encourage you to reach out, look in your area for a kinesiologist or a nutritional response tester, or you can reach out to Health by Design Florida and make an appointment virtually with one of their practitioners and be able to get your journey started and find out what supplements you specifically need for your body and get the real whole food kind of supplements instead of the chemical drugstore ones that are going to do more harm than good. So thank you so much for being on the Warrior Wellness Podcast, Dr. Christie.
Thanks for having me. It was super fun.
Captain Lincoln here. Thanks so much for joining us for another episode of the Warrior Wellness Podcast. go on over to iTunes and Spotify and subscribe to us. And while you're there, leave us a review. Screenshot your review and send it to us at info@fireteamwhiskey.com, and we will send you some awesome Fireteam Whiskey swag.